knocked you out.
You need to get out of my face.
Shut up.
Why am I my shirt? Because you're mad about it?
I've never known about your shirt.
Oh, you said you said ugly outfit.
I never said ugly outfit. I called you ugly.
You said rude outfit. That's what you said. Don't talk.
Shut up. I'll take you outside. Shut up.
What are you going
to
do?
I'll take you outside and beat the crap out of you.
Oh, really?
Shut up.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
Don't you call me your grandma. I'll put your little butt down there and mash. You just knock.
Get out of my face.
You get out of my face.
Don't touch me. Back up.
Don't touch me. You don't tell me to back up.
Get out of my face.
Shut up. You shut your mouth.
All right.
Or you going to get it smashed.
You think I'm scared of you?
Okay.
You think I'm scared of you?
Back up.
You shut up.
Come on. She's sticking.
You ain't got no respect for.
The OG Karen here is the only disrespectful person I see, period. Why did this start? Because the young lady is wearing a pro-choice t-shirt, okay? Think about the irony of this. You have a violent, elderly Karen who should have matured out of this kind of back and forth because of a person's choice to wear a shirt. Think about the irony here. Not only does she say a woman should not have choice about her own body, what this Karen is saying is that you should not even have choice over what shirt you wear on a given day. That makes me upset, according to this particular Karen. Is it not strange that virtually every conservative who is, as they say, pro-life, are so pro-violence and pro-death and pro-death penalty and pro-war and pro-defunding programs that actually take care of children when they are birthed into the world? I still can't understand how Democrats allowed them to hijack the terminology pro-life. All right? Okay. She was, according to the report, let's put a picture up full mass here. She was kicked out of that particular Walmart. But as of now, we don't have much more information. More information, I'm sure, is yet to come. Sharon?
I noticed things, and I just love this segment. You know how much I adore it because it's eye-opening and it's entertaining and it's tragic too. But I pay attention to everything when these Karens are recorded. And did you notice which aisle she was in, this OG Karen? It was full of processed food and chemical additives. And I happen to be reading a study. This is a huge coincidence, Dr. Richey. And it talks about how these processed foods, look at them, bag after bag after bag, full of salt and nonsense and things you can't pronounce. It leads to mood swings, irritability. Did you know that? That's what happens. So as we study more and more of these Karens, no matter the age, we're getting clues to their habitat and what's leading them to their behaviors. They're leading little drops and showing us where we can go to figure out how to solve this thing.
This is so interesting because we are literally keeping a research guidebook here about documenting certain nuances of Karenicity. You may have discovered something. There may be, listen, dare I say, there may be a formula to correct this behavior. We're willing to try anything right now. This epidemic is out of damn control. I need white women to hold a press conference and figure out what's going on in their communities all across this planet. All right.